Bottlenose dolphins are almost universally the creatures that come to mind when one hears the word dolphin, even though there are dozens of other species. Bottlenose dolphins hail from the Tursiops genus. However, like many animals we've covered here on AFF, their classification is debated. It's largely agreed that there are two species of bottlenose dolphins, common bottlenose dolphins and Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphins. There may also be a third species called Burinan dolphins, after the language of Australian natives, though this has not been widely accepted in the scientific community. We, on AFF, are happy to accept them because, well, why not? But it is possible that bottlenose dolphin classification could change significantly with more research. Common bottlenose dolphins live throughout the ocean's warmer waters, while Indo-Pacific and Burinan dolphins are found mainly along the coasts of Australia. Some groups of bottlenose dolphins, called pods, prefer to live closer to shore, while others like living out in the open ocean. While coastal living bottlenose dolphins are generally slightly smaller than their offshore neighbors, on average, a bottlenose dolphin is about 12 feet long once full grown, with common bottlenose dolphins being the largest species. In color, bottlenose dolphins can range from pale gray to dark charcoal. Their dorsal, or top half, is darker than their ventral, or bottom half, which can appear nearly white. Color varies through individual dolphins, and older dolphins can even sport speckled patterns. It's like they're developing liver spots. Bottlenose dolphins can live to be older than 50, with females living slightly longer than males. The age they're ready to mate can be anywhere from 5 to 15 years old, with females maturing slightly faster than males. The age of sexual maturity largely depends on how long bottlenose babies end up staying with their mother. Female bottlenose dolphins gestate for a year. The baby is born live and there are tiny little hairs growing on her nose. Like all mammals, dolphins have hair, but theirs begins to fall out as they swim more. They also drink milk, and a dolphin baby may drink his mother's milk for 2 years or longer. There was even a report of a male bottlenose baby who stayed with his mom for more than a decade. Huh, and I thought Chester was a mama's boy. Bottlenose dolphins learn to hunt during their time with their mother. They'll eat fish, cephalopods, and crustaceans, and they all have different ways of collecting these meals. It's pretty widely believed that dolphins are some of the smartest animals in the world. Some dolphins have been taught to open puzzles in a collaborative effort in order to reach fish inside. Others seem to be able to recognize their own reflection and even actively watch TV. So it's no surprise that bottlenose dolphins, specifically Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphins, have been observed using sea sponges to protect their noses while foraging on the ocean floor. This phenomenon is the first recorded use of tools by dolphins, a trait not shared throughout most of the animal kingdom. Although dolphins are smarty pants, they're still not completely out of harm's way. Because some bottlenose dolphins live close to shore, they intermingle with humans frequently. Often, bottlenose dolphins are caught in fishing nets, an interaction which can prove fatal. They're also in danger of impact from boats, especially when they're enticed to boats with bait and fishing leftovers. Actually, it's completely illegal to feed any kind of dolphin in America as well as some other parts of the world, and they should be given distance when observing them to help keep them and observers safe. Sharks, including tiger, bull, and great white sharks, also attack bottlenose dolphins and seem to specifically target bottlenose babies. This can be a contributing factor to higher mortality rates in younger bottlenose dolphins. Plus, many adults bear scars relating to shark attacks. I suppose it makes sense that dolphins themselves can be pretty brutal if they have to worry about sharks when they're still an infant. In general, though, bottlenose dolphins are curious and playful creatures who form friendly bonds in pods that can change throughout the day and can even include other animal species. It's atypical to see a single roving bottlenose dolphin, though it does happen. Their energetic and fun-loving attitude has landed them as a symbol of positivity to us landlubbers. For more facts on bottlenose dolphins, take a look at the links in the description. There's a lot more that we couldn't fit into just one episode. Once again, we'd like to thank the Victoria Museum and Gallery for their awesome requests. Be sure to stay tuned because there are some awesome animals coming up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Animal Fact Files.